Hey guys, what's happening? This is Roby here with another Divi engine quick tip for you using our Divi Machine plugin. Today I'll be showing you how to add some CSS to transform your loop layouts using the conditional logic found in the .acf item module in Divi Machine. What am I talking about? Well, let's go take a look. Right, so here we are. This that you're looking at is a custom post type based on breakfast menu. That's what this custom post type is called. And what you're looking at on the page here is a loop. So this is a loop, that's a loop, that's a loop. And these are all individual custom posts that we created in that breakfast menu custom post type. So how do we do all of this? Well, let's take a look. If I come in here and I am in that stacker burger, this one you see right here, and I scroll down a bit, here we see the advanced custom field that we added called dish status. And you'll see that there's three options. There's none, we gave it the option of new, and recommended. And now what's important here to use that conditional logic, it needs to be either a select dropdown or a checkbox field type. So just bear that in mind. So what do we do with that? Now we're gonna look at the loop here. Now, this is the loop that was constructed, and here you can see that ACF item field, and this is the one for the status. So when I come to the top here and I expand main options, you'll see that the ACF name, so that the field that we're selecting here is the dish status. And when we scroll down to the conditional settings, another important thing here, you need to make sure that you flip this switch to yes, checkbox select, because it's going to look at that field and therefore the class that we're adding, so the part that we're appending. And then we also need to make sure, since this is a loop, we want to make sure that we just flip this to yes. Also, is this a loop layout so that it knows to look for that? Next up, we look at the CSS selector here. This means this is what it's going to look on the page to go ahead and identify it. We can expand this here. Here we say again, we're looking for the target, and that's the grid item cont. And then lastly, the CSS name prefix, it's going to be status dash, since we're looking at the status, and it's going to assign the value that we see right here in this item. So for this one, it's new. So what it's going to do, it's going to make this status dash new. So now we've got all of that in there. How do we get it to look all fancy like this with a border and, you know, this gray color or the yellow color or whatever you do? Simple. In the back end of Divi Machine, in the settings area, you just scroll over to the general settings, you go to add some custom CSS or JS, and here you'll see all those classes. Grid item cont, but then it's got that class that it constructs using the conditional logic. And for status new, here's the styles for that. For recommended, the styles for that, and so forth. You can do all sorts of cool stuff with this. It's the way in this hamburger shop layout that we have available for you to download with Divi Machine that we create these items. So let's quickly take a look and see what happens if I make the stacker burger recommended. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to make it recommended and I will update the post. And then I'm going to go back to the burger. I'm going to refresh the menu page and it changes to recommended as if by magic. It is a really cool way that you can give your site some depth and create some awesome complex websites. So there you have it, guys. This is conditional logic in the .acf item module in Divi Machine. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to the channel, like the video, please. And please let us know if this is working for you. That's it from me, Roby with the Divi Engine team. I'm going to catch you in the next tip.